Hello everyone, this is your science teacher. Today we will start the periodic table, our new lesson. First, the lesson objectives, what you will learn in this video. You will learn elements, periodic table, the atomic number, chemical symbol, and average atomic mass will be taught today. Get organized. What are elements? It was once believed that fire, wind, earth, and water in various combinations made up all objects. As you see in this cartoon as well, anime as well, they are also mentioning the same ideology.
Water. Earth. Fire. Air. Long ago, the four nations lived together in harmony. Then, everything changed when the Fire Nation attacked. Only the Avatar, master of all four elements, could stop them. But when the world needed him most, he vanished.
Yeah, four elements. They suppose that the just four elements are present in the Earth. But when we came to 1860s, scientists considered there are to be at least 60 different basic substances or elements. Okay? Scientists found that many of these elements have similar properties and began classifying them. Okay, now those 60 elements, the first 60 elements are discovered, or all those 60 elements, they realized that all of them has same property. Yeah, some of them has same property, the others has, you know, different properties in common. Look, for example, the copper here, mercury, and the bismuth, both the three of them are shiny, right? They are shiny, but you see sulfur, chlorine, and bromine are not shiny. You see, they don't shine. Why? Because because of their chemical properties, or you may say which ones are metallic. You may say that copper, mercury, and bismuth are metallic, but others are non-metallic. You are able to see that actually their properties also different, and we are able to group according to their properties, right? So what scientists has done, actually they group they group the all elements according to their properties. Okay, look at here. Dmitri Mendeleev the first organized the elements by arranging them in order of increasing atomic mass. Look, increasing the atomic mass number, they classify them first of all. Okay, by he observed that the properties of those elements were in a periodic or regularly repeating pattern. You are able to see the I will explain the different properties as well. The same properties are actually followed by on the horizontal line in the periodic table, right? In the vertical line also some of them are repeated, right? That's why actually this table is called as an this table is called as a periodic table. Now look at here. Mendeleev, scientist who discovered actually the periodic table, arranges the 64 elements. Now there are, you see, 118 elements here. You are able to see the last element, this one, 18 elements. But in that time, the just 64 elements were known at that time into the first modern periodic table, and correctly predicts several others. You see, he actually added the like gold, copper, the like hydrogen, etc., carbon in the periodic table, but the others one are not known, right? Like osmium, like uranium, for example. The others are unknown. What did they do? He actually predicted the place of the other elements, because you know he saw that each and every element is actually in the are present on the periodic table in the form in the same property. For example, with the same order of the atomic number. 24, if there is, for example, if there is 42 to and 44, there is exactly 43 there. And he said that it will be also discovered in near future. The other elements like 84, 85 will be also discovered. Okay? Because there, atomic number are fit on the, you know, periodic table, but they were not discovered yet in that time. Then they say, he said that it will be also discovered, right? Because you know there is an harmony in the universe. Okay, there is a system in the universe. Everything is not randomly actually spread on the earth. Each and every elements are not, you know, spontaneously by the coincidence they are produced. Okay, they are all having one wisdom, they are all having one purpose to be in the earth. As you see everything in the system, and it is seen in the even chemistry. There is one who designed this all. In the universe, everything in harmony. Now, Mendeleev's arrangement of the elements became known as periodic table. Henry reorganized Mendeleev's periodic table in order of increasing number of protons or atomic number. The periodic table is useful because it makes clear many patterns among the elements' properties. Okay? Yani if, for example, here, look at here, if one element is discovered over here and the oxygen is not discovered yet, understand? But fluorine is discovered, the oxygen is missing here, for example. The scientist can predict the property of this element. Why? Because he says that, okay, if nitrogen is non-metal, fluorine also non-metal, the element between the nitrogen and fluorine also should be non-metal, right? When the oxygen also discovered, oh, they say, okay, it is also non-metal, as you see. Okay, for example, here also same. If one element is metal, the other also non-metal, then between them there are elements, then they are also what actually metal, we can say. Yeah, right. We are able to understand their chemical or also physical properties. What can you learn about an element from the periodic table? Also, guys, in the periodic table, we know that the properties, physical and chemical properties, are repeated on the horizontal line on the periodic table, right? Now, we are able to understand that some of the elements are, for example, just in the state of gas, right? Just it can be seen in the state of gas, because to convert it into solid, we need to decrease the temperature a lot. In that time, what happens? The solid form of that element, okay, has the property. That properties cannot be seen by the scientist, but it can be predicted by the scientist by the observing the other elements. Okay, the other elements nearby it on the periodic table. Okay, that's why we are able to learn many things on the periodic table. Okay, for the unknown elements, for the unknown state of the elements as well. I hope you understood. Okay, what else we are able to see on the periodic table? We are able to see, guys, we are able to see the numbers or name of the element, okay, atomic mass of the element on the periodic table as well. Look, each square contains an element's chemical name, atomic number, chemical symbol, and average atomic mass also can be seen on the each square which belongs to one element. The atomic number is placed at the top of each square. You see, you are able to see here the 8. Oxygen has 8 protons. That's why its atomic number is 8. Okay? Atomic number is 8 and it can be seen at the top of the square. Now, the chemical symbol is an abbreviation of the element's name. Okay? Sometimes it has one letter. Sometimes it has two letters, sometimes it has three letters, okay? Oxygen has just one letter, for example, right? The iron has two, like that. The first letter of the chemical symbol is always capitalized, and any other letter is lowercase. For example, here, oxygen is there, that's the beginning of the oxygen starts with the O. O is actually capitalized, okay? With the capital letter, it can be shown. If it is, for example, iron, then first letter should be capitalized. The second letter of the element symbol should be shown with the lowercase letter E, okay? Fe for iron. You got it? Now, the name of the element is written under the symbol. You see, the name of the, you know, whole name of the element can be seen under the symbol, a chemical symbol as well in the square. Right? And let me clean up here. Yeah. Now, all atoms of an element have the same number of protons, but the number of neutrons can vary. You know that isotopes of the same element has different number of the neutrons. That's why the atomic mass number can be changed isotope to isotope. That's why what scientist has written here, you are not able to write 1, 2, 3, atomic mass on this same square. That's why the scientist has taken their average. The average atomic mass of an atom is weighted average of the masses of all natural occurring isotopes of that element. Okay? All isotopes has different number of the neutrons, but same number of the atomic number protons, definitely they have different number of the atomic mass. What scientists has done, they took the average of the all isotopes, the average of the atomic mass for the oxygen of all isotopes of the oxygen, then they have written at the bottom of the, you know, the box in for that element. Average atomic mass is reported in atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit, I have mentioned it, okay? U belongs to actually one proton and also one neutron, okay? One neutron as heavy as one U. And how many neutrons are there? How many protons are there? Then you may say that, okay, 8 neutrons are there. The total atomic mass is 15. Okay, 0.999. It means that the total amount of average amount of neutron mass, mass of the neutron is, you may say, 7.999. Okay? When you add 8 plus 7.999, you will find 15.999, whatsoever. Okay? Guys, I hope you enjoy it. This is the end of the video. Have a nice day.